Hello everyone and welcome to third episode of Filty Live, bringing you more productivity and safety at your construction job site. I am Akash, your digital account manager, connecting with you all live via Facebook. In last few episodes, we discussed about Filty Tool Repair Services and our dust-free technology. And if you missed any of the episodes, you do not need to worry, because we have posted a link in the description of the video below from where you can watch all our episodes on our YouTube playlist. So do not forget to click on that. And today we are going to discuss about how you can increase productivity at your construction job site. In current business scenario, it is utmost important that you should be as much productive as you can because of labor shortage and cost pressure. And Hilti cordless solution is one of the best ways to be as much productive as you can on the construction job site. And to present Hilti innovation of cordless tools, today with us is my colleague Sharan Gurover, product manager of Light Duty Tools. So hi Sharan, how are you?
Hi Akash, good to be here, and hello to all our viewers out there.
Thanks for joining us Sharan. And guys, let's quickly discuss three things that we will be discussing today. First, why cordless and how does it help? Second, what are some of the applications of cordless tool on a construction job site? Third, discuss and address some of the myths regarding cordless tools. So stay tuned and please feel free to share your questions or opinions in the comment section below, because we will be answering them at the end of the episode. And now, Sharan, tell us why we should use cordless tools and what's the advantage over corded tools?
That's a very fair question, Akash, and one that most of the industry is asking today. So rather than me give a theoretical answer to that, let's quickly do a corded cordless face-off for a particular application, and then the answers will become pretty clear. What do you think of that?
Sounds perfect.
So what would you like to use? Cordless or the old corded systems?
Given a choice, I would like to go with cordless tools. Who doesn't want to be more productive if given a choice?
Good choice, Akash.
Thanks, Sharan. So guys, what we will be doing in this demo is, we will be fixing this base plate with the mechanical anchors, and for the sake of time, we will fix only two mechanical anchors for now, and we'll compare the time between the cordless solution and the corded solution. And the anchor that we are using today is our Hilti HSA M12 dia anchor. And the drill machine that I will be using for drilling is T6A cordless drill machine with onboard dust removal system for a cleaner and a safer environment. And the tool that I will be using for tightening the anchor is SIW680 with adaptive torque module, which helps you install the mechanical anchors at the right torque. And now let me show you how. So you can see this anchor box, and there is a QR code mentioned over here. And what we can do with the help of our adaptive torque module is, you can see over here there's a scanner, and at the back there's a display screen with the options. And now let me switch it on. And now what I have to do is, if I have to identify which anchor we are installing today, I have to press the scanner button. And now I will put it on the QR code. And you see a green light, which shows that it has scanned which anchors are inside this tool in the anchor box, and it shows HSA M12. And now I lock it, and now what will happen is, it will automatically cut off after giving the right torque as per ETA approval for HSA M12 anchor. Also guys, if you are not having an anchor box on the job site, you do not need to worry, because you can select the anchor in the adaptive torque module yourself with the options given. And now let's see what tool Sharan will be using for the demo.
Akash, you did not leave me with much choice. So I'll be going with the corded systems here. We'll be doing drilling with the corded drill machine, a T3. And that is of the same drilling range as the T6A which you have. So the comparison will be pretty fair, right? And to tighten my anchor, I'll be using the traditional spanner. Yeah. I'll give you a tough fight, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, let's see. And what I will do is now, I will open the stopwatch in my phone, and before starting the stopwatch, let's wear our gloves. And now let me start the stopwatch. So we have started the game.
I'll go find some power.
And I do not need to do so because we are using cordless solution. A blowout pump to clean the hole, which is required for mechanical anchors as well. And let me place the base plate over here now. And we are having the anchors. And now let me remove the DRS system. And for making sure that our anchor goes till the right embedment depth, which is marked with the blue mark, I will use this setting tool. And now I will be using SIW680, and you will see a green light will blink as soon as we give the right torque. So here we go. You see this green light and it has automatically cut off. And that's it, we are done. And I have taken 1 minute 45 seconds to complete the demo. And let me take out my gloves. Also guys, now you can see Sharan is still continuing with the traditional method. And this is what I have seen generally on the job site. That first of all, it takes a lot of time and energy to arrange the cables and the wires on different floors. Also, I have seen many a times there is a power failure with my own experience, and it reduces productivity a lot. And now, you can see Sharan will be using a spanner to tighten the anchors. And first of all, it takes a lot of time and energy to tighten the anchors with the help of spanner. Secondly, you do not come to know whether you are putting the right torque for fixing the anchors or not, because ETA specifically mentioned that this is the amount of torque that is required. And then you are unsure of the quality, whether the anchor has been installed correctly or not. And this is what our adaptive torque module helps you with. And let me explain you one more feature of our adaptive torque module. So let me take out the battery. And from here you can take out your adaptive torque module. And you see in this adaptive torque module, there's a USB port over here. And the benefit of the USB port is you can connect this adaptive torque module with your laptop, and you will get details of all the anchors that you have installed with the help of SIW680. And then you can document it as a report. Isn't it easy, exciting, and simple? Also guys, now you can wonder that if you have to install almost 500 or 1000 number of anchors on the job site using a spanner, how much time taking process it will be, how much productive loss it will give, and secondly, you do not come to know whether the quality of work is correct or not. And I can see now it's almost 4 minutes that Sharan has been doing with the help of corded tools, and still not completed. So finally, Sharan,
I'm done,
has completed. Yeah. So ooh. Sharan, how was your experience? Like, you have taken almost 4 minutes, whereas I did in less than 2 minutes.
It wasn't fun, Akash. Absolutely not fun at all. First of all, I had to go look for power. That wasted my time. Then I had to manually hammer the anchor in. It was a slow and tedious process. But the worst part was the tightening part, the torquing, you know. I just went on and on and on. I had no idea about how much, you know, to tighten. So I just went as far as my muscle strength
and
allowed me.
Yeah, sometimes
I don't know whether.
Yeah. And sometimes over torque.
Correct. So it wasn't a good experience doing it in the traditional way. It was very less productive as well. And I think, as we saw from the clock, the cordless system was about 2 times faster than my method, right?
Yes.
So that's the answer for you and our US today. what's the advantage of going cordless, you know, save on time, be safer, and unnecessarily these cords, boards, plugs, those hidden costs, they can get eliminated.
Thanks, Sharon, for answering the first question so beautifully. And now let's discuss that there are some myths in the industry about the cordless tools, such as less power, less lifetime of the battery, right, and less life of tool itself. So what's your take on that?
Right, Akash, these are some of the myths which have been around, and let's address them one by one. The first point is about the battery, right? That batteries don't last long enough. Maybe that was true many years ago, but with the advent of lithium ion, it has become much more possible to package energy into a small cell, you know. So that battery technology has evolved over the years, and that problem does not really exist now. Also, one of the advantages, or let's call it the flexibility with Hilti batteries, is that we have got, if you have a look here, we have got three different battery types on our 22 volt platform. The first is the compact class. This is meant for lighter applications, as you can see, B22 2.6. These are for lighter applications like screw driving, etc., where not much, you know, intensity is required. And then on the other side, we've got the ultimate class battery, the B22-8, for extremely heavy usage applications like, you know, serial drilling, grinding, cutting, all these kind of applications. This battery is a good fit. And then we've got one which is in between the two, you know, like a middle kind of battery. So what we can do is, depending on the application, we understand the usage and we can assist our customers select the right battery or group of batteries to make their tool pack. You know, you don't need to have a battery with every tool or two batteries with every tool. It is very application dependent, and that's where we can help out at site. And one more thing I would like to show you here. This battery is compatible with all of these tools. So in case I have an application which demands driving small screws, or let's say even drilling in steel, I do it with this tool first. After that, I feel like doing some sawing. I bring this out here and it works. So this versatility is also available with Hilti cordless.
And guys, now if you are wondering about the power of the tool, that was the second myth. I think we have just done the demo and we have seen that the power and the performance of cordless tool and cordless tools are same. And now let's discuss about the third myth, which is regarding the life of cordless tool itself.
Yeah, Akash, that's another point. There is another perception that cordless tools will have a lesser lifetime compared to their corded counterparts, right? Yes. This is also incorrect.
Okay.
With cordless tools, there is technology. We have designed them to be robust and made for industry and construction. One of the things we have inside is an overload protection. Many of the tools are brushless, and this definitely aids to increasing the life of the tool, right? Additionally, standard wear and tear of a tool, if it has to be covered and maintenance has to happen, we do that perfectly well, free of cost, 2 years from the date of invoicing. So all labor, pickup, spares are completely covered 2 years from the date of invoicing. So we have all our customers covered.
Sounds perfect. And guys, now if you are wondering about the charging and the charging time of the battery, then to tell you, our batteries are very quick to charge. To just give you an example, this is a 5.2 ampere battery, and if you are charging it with our fast charger, it will take only 35 minutes. And if you are charging it with our universal charger, it will take only 75 minutes.
Right.
Also guys, we say that in Hilti, our batteries are differentiated. And let me explain you some of the features why our battery are differentiated. First, our batteries are powerful and have a long run life. Second, our batteries are intelligent. What it means is, you see written over here, CPC. This is a technology which prevents overloading, overheating, deep discharge. Also, it ensures that a constant output is maintained, whether your battery is 40% charged or 100% charged. Third, our batteries are robust. That means we have a glass fiber housing, which gives you 4 times impact resistant with the normal plastic. And now, let's discuss that. Sharon, would you like to tell us what all tools that we have got in Hilti with cordless portfolio, and what are some of the applications we can cover with them on the job site?
Sure, I'd love to do that, Akash. Let's start on this side of the table. We have our cordless rotary hammers We already saw one of them in action. These are specialist concrete drillers. And this particular one, the T6A, is pretty versatile. It can be used with, it has a removable chuck, so it can be used for occasional drilling in wood and steel as well. Additionally, you saw the functionality of the DRS. So this comes with that onboard DRS attachment if required, ensuring a dust-free environment for your workforce, right? A less dust environment for your workforce. So this is about the T6A. Then moving on the right, we have our range of impact wrenches. We already saw this specialist impact wrench in action, the SIW680 with the adaptive torque technology. Additional to this, we also have other impact wrenches for larger torque, larger bolt diameters, with this SIW9 being suitable for high torque applications like structural bolting. So this can do the job for even high torque applications. Let's move here. We have our set of cutting, sawing and grinding tools, right? And we have some good specialists here which I like to talk about. So the first specialist we have is the SCM22A. This is meant for cutting metal. So you can cut steel, stainless steel, aluminium with it. One of the beautiful features is that it cuts, gives a cold cut, right? And it does not give the same level of sparks that a standard grinder does. A clean, cold cut with less sparks. And then we have another specialist here, the SCW, which is for your wood drywall cutting, extremely long lasting blade. So some advantage there. Then we have the standard angle grinder, a 5-inch angle grinder, which packs the power of a corded system. It also has a dead man switch for safety of the user. Here we have the SCO6A, which is a specialist drywall cutout tool. So you can make out, you know, cutouts of all shapes and sizes, just like this, when you are working on drywall applications. And then coming to this side of the table, we have a range of drill drivers, screwdrivers and impact drivers. In general, just to put it simply, what this does is you can drill into steel, wood, and also drive occasionally screws and small bolts with this kind of tool. It has a 3-jaw chuck, so it's pretty versatile. And the last tool which we would like to mention is our cordless dispenser. So the HD500. This dispenser is used for injecting chemicals, right? So not only does it add productivity than the manual guns that you have, but you can also turn the knob here, and with some metering, you can adjust the exact amount of chemical which should flow, you know, so that your wastage becomes much lesser. So not only does this add productivity, but it also reduces unnecessary wastage as well. Applications.
Applications, yes, that is the second topic.
That's the main point. So all of these tools can cover a wide range of application. Just to give you a few examples, we saw the mechanical anchoring one. Mechanical anchors, base plate fixing can be done. We can do chemical anchors, we can do rebar, shuttering, wooden and Mi-1 both. The full drywall application can be made cordless, Akash.
Yeah.
And racking as well, you know. All our racking customers would love these because they have tight timelines, and it would definitely aid their productivities. We are constantly adding more tools, so there are many more applications that we can cover, but as of now, just a nutshell.
Also, from my personal experience, I have seen on infra projects, like road projects and tunnel projects, where they are present in remote location.
Absolutely.
And secondly, there's less power, less electricity available.
Right.
These are one of the best solution that you can have. And if you are working in any such project where the power is inaccessible, then you know you deserve to have our cordless solutions. And now is the time when you will be answering few of the questions that you have posted in the comment section below. And let me have a look. So I am going live in the session to see your comments. And I can see Rajan Shukla has asked us that does Hilti provides warranty on batteries as well? So thanks for asking this question, sir. And Sharon, would you like to answer this question for us?
Sure, I'll do that. Simple answer, yes. So all our, like I mentioned, all our tools, batteries and chargers are covered under the 2-year no-cost service warranty, which means from the date of invoicing, we will cover labor, spare, pickup, drop, everything free of cost for 2 years. In case of batteries and chargers, if there is a defect found, we'll replace them.
We'll replace them.
So yeah, we have you covered, like I mentioned.
So hope that answers your question, sir. And guys, please feel free to post your questions in the comment section below, because we will be ensuring to reply each one of you after the end of the episode. And now, let's quickly summarize what we have discussed today in the episode. Insurance, since you are with us today, would you like to summarize what we discussed today?
Absolutely. So, to start off, we saw the advantage of cordless and the kind of speed and productivity that it brings, right?
Yeah.
Second, we busted some myths with respect to cordless. Example, that battery life is low, or the tool doesn't last as long, or the power is less, you know. We don't have such things. These are myths, and we kind of busted them through our demonstration today. And we also learned that over the period of time, you know, we can remove the cost of cords, plugs, boards, coupled with this 2-year wear and tear coverage that we bring. It enables all our customers to have a much lower tool cost of ownership. So that's the advantage of cordless, that's the power of cordless, and we saw that today, Akash.
Also guys, we have posted a link in the description of the video below from where you can download the catalog of all the cordless tools that you have discussed today. So do not forget to click on that. And that's it from our side in today's episode. I hope you enjoyed the live session with my colleague Sharon Grover. It was an amazing experience to interact with you all. Next episode, we will be coming up with another Hilti innovation where we'll be talking about Hilti direct passing technology. So stay tuned, stay safe. Till then, take care of yourself and see you all in the next episode.